Hear this prayer we sing to you. Spoils and riches be our pursuit. Bypass the natural order to, and bless us with the rights of the Institute.
Friday morning, 8:40 a.m. Jam is late to his art movements and culture class. He checks himself in the mirror on his way out the door. He looks presentable, at least. And he's out. Jam hops on the nearest app-driven commuter scooter. Dead battery. He runs to find another scooter nearby using the GPS. In use. Flustered by the time he's wasting, Jam decides to run to the bus stop instead. The sounds of Friday morning traffic fill the air. A brisk fall morning. Jam reaches the corner of St. Paul in Utah. And he misses the express bus stop by just a second.
Damn!
Better luck next time, Jam.
It's Jam, Louie. Jam!
Oh, Jam! I saw you on TV.
Sure you did, Louie.
Jam pulls out his phone and opens Instagram. He takes a selfie. Caption, late again. Someone cash out me purple taxi money. Frowny face.
Yes, I did. You shook hands with the man.
Ain't no way in hell I'm ever shaking hands with that crook. What do you want, Louie? I don't have any money for you today.
Oh, then what are you good for then? Absolutely nothing. And you owe me for that oracle reading.
What oracle reading?
The one I just gave you about being on TV. That's worth two coffees.
Oh, so you're an oracle reader now. Last week you were a dog whisperer. On TV. I believe it when I see it.
We'll believe it, Jim, because your life's about to change forever.
The Cash App notification reads, for a purple taxi, love, ways. Jam blushes. He opens up the purple taxi app and orders a ride to school. The taxi pulls up to the Center for the Arts.
And that's why Ye should have just cut his losses and stayed with Adidas. I mean, the Gap? Who even shops there anymore?
Well, plenty of people shop there because of its accessibility, and what am I saying? I gotta get to class! Thanks for the ride!
9:40 a.m. Jam glides across the lobby and into the Orion Lecture Hall. The door opens up with a loud creak, completely blowing his cover. Everybody turns around and stares.
Oh, hey, y'all! Oh, wow, they should really get this door checked out. Am I right? Maintenance?
Jam, grab a seat.
Yes, sir.
Jam grabs an auditorium seat one row behind his cohort. A total of 9 students make up the Graduate Theater Arts program. They're all athletic. They have interesting stories to tell at parties. And then there's Jam.
As you can see, Jill Scott Heron wasn't just some ordinary poet. He was an observer of his environment. He took in his experiences being raised in the ghetto and reflected it back to the powers that be in a cool and funky way. We're expecting quite an exhilarating presentation on Mr. Scott Heron by Jam on Monday. You are prepared, right?
Huh? Oh yeah! This presentation will not be televised! Y'all get it? Cause Gil... Also, please don't record the presentation cause I get nervous when I teach in front of people, so...
Well, that's time. Thank you all.
The class packs their things. WAEZ, a member of the cohort with a concentration in prop design, taps Jam on the shoulder before he leaves.
Are you forgetting something?
Oh, thank you so much for the money. It helped me out a lot. I will pay you back first thing next week.
No, silly. Here, your pen.
WAEZ holds out a button pen. The pen is about the size of a silver dollar, and on it is Jam's artist logo. 2 purple arrows point to northeast, and 1 pink arrow opposing the 2 in the other direction.
Oh my god, WAEZ. This is amazing. Really. Thank you.
No worries. I love how it turned out. Here, I'll pin it on you. There. Now you're officially Jamboomboom.
Right. Hey, what are you doing after class? I got some time before I work on my presentation, and I was wondering if you'd like to...
Jam. A word in my office, please.
Never mind. I'll text you.
Sure. Be strong, Boom.
Jam enters Professor Professorstein's office. It's a small nook with low lightning. Large books stack from the ground up. The walls are decorated with Professor Stein's various accolades. There is a plush red sofa along the side wall and a bust statue of some old dead man sitting on a table.
Have a seat, Jam. This is the fourth lateness in 2 weeks. I'm starting to be concerned that the pressure to perform is too much for you.
I know, Professor Stein. It's just, honestly, it's beginning to be a lot for me.
What is? You've known about the class schedule since the middle of winter.
No. I mean, this whole discovering your artist aesthetic. 1 week, I feel like I'm the voice of my generation. And the next week, I feel like a struggling artist. Then the week after that, I feel like Lauryn Hill.
Look, Jam, as your advisor, I'm here to try and help guide you in a certain direction. We're doing all we can. Take, for instance, last week when we invited Eurasian punk, Afrofuturist throat singer James Foxy Lynn Hugh for our guest artist series. We invited them with you in mind, and you were a no-show. How do you think that makes us look?
Terrible, I know, but throat singing isn't my thing. Maybe if I had a say in who to invite as a guest artist here, I would be more prone to showing up.
We handpick artists based on general interests and demographics of the cohort. And she was the only artist we could find who looks like you. You do have a pretty unique aesthetic from what I've seen so far on your Instagram page.
Professor Stein pulls up Jam's Instagram page. A remix of Mary, My Maryland plays.
Desperate here lives on the shore, Maryland, my Maryland. His torch is at my temple door, Maryland, my Maryland. A visual patriotic gore, deflect the street of Baltimore, and be the battle queen of yore, Maryland, my Maryland.
So you like my remix? I thought of it as the satirical take on the scrutiny of the citizens of
this. Look, the point is that you will eventually find your style. You will find your voice if you stick with the program and take our advice. We're here to guide you and mold you into the amazing young artist of your time, if you heed to our advice.
Okay, so what is your advice?
I thought you'd never ask.
Professor Stein takes out a flyer from his pocket and hands it the Jam.
The mayor's annual Poor Man's Beat Poet Fest?
Yes, you have until the end of today to submit your application. Luckily, I did the favor of submitting the application on your behalf. Isn't that great?
I mean, no, it isn't.
What do you mean?
I'm no beat poet, sir. And I don't want to be associated with anything having to do with our local government, to be frank.
Jam, this is a perfect opportunity for someone like you. Great exposure.
Yeah, but it's not me.
You just said a minute ago that you didn't know who you were as an artist.
Yeah, but I know who I'm not.
Look, maybe you just need the weekend to collect your thoughts, yeah? I expect your presentation on Mr. Gil Scott Heron to be nothing short of amazing. Your grade depends on it. You may leave now.
Jam heads for the door.
You cannot be mad at us, Jam. Don't forget it was you who decided to pursue this particular institution.
Yeah. Well, it's times like these that has me questioning what it is I'm really pursuing, sir.